thank you very much, Congresswoman Norton, and thank you, Congressman Hoyer, for bringing us here today. So we know that the post office has a 90% approval rating, and Annette told us that 92% of Americans support funding to make sure that the Postal Service is strong. So we know that, but have you ever thought about why that is? The reason for that is because of people like Annette Taylor. It's that special bond between the letter carrier and the customer on the front line. People who've come to rely on the post office, they know they can count on them. They trust them. So when you attack the Postal Service the way Louis DeJoy has been doing, you're trying to break what's almost become, with an institution so revered in this country as the Postal Service, you're trying to break a sacred bond between the letter carrier and the customer, between the Postal Service and the public. And that's not right. I'll tell you, I hear right now in my mind the voice of Elijah Cummings. And Louis DeJoy should be counting his blessings that Elijah's not here for this moment, because I can't even imagine what he would be doing. He cared for the men and women of the U.S. Postal Service. He made it a number one commitment of his to try to strengthen the Postal Service. So when you attack the workings of the Postal Service, you're asking these letter carriers to go against their nature. Annette said it. You don't want to leave out on your route unless you have 100% of the mail in your bag. And they're being told to leave with 50% or 25%. It cuts against their nature of commitment and service to their customers. But we're not standing for it, and the American public's not standing for it. The emails and the calls that we've been getting in our offices have been saying to us, we've got a problem getting our mail, but you know what they've been saying more than that? Stand up for the Postal Service. Fight back against these changes. Honor the people like Annette Taylor who've been serving us day in and day out for so many years and building that trusted relationship between the public and this treasured institution, the United States Postal Service. And now it's my pleasure to turn it over to Congressman Anthony Brown.